step by step, it will take time. So otherwise what happened, it is like a radio.
This conference will now be recorded.
Very good. Now, okay, I thought you are asking in Windows 10. That's why I opened Windows 10 now. We can open it later or you can leave it like that. So we can, no, that's not a big deal. So here we are going to discuss about domain controller. How to set up a domain controller. Whenever you want to set up a domain, first of all, when you want to set up a domain, so domain is a logical one. It means there is no physical entity kind of stuff. But without a domain controller, so you can't create a domain. First of all, so we are creating a domain by installing of domain controller. So that there must be a centralized administrator to make possible as a domain. So domain is a group. It's a group, okay? So the group is belongs to someone. So some name of the group is there. Like as I think I said one example, right? A political party. So you want to start a party, its name, it's not just a name, right? It's a group of people in the party. So first, someone should start the party. Someone should be a leader. Someone who should be there are what we can say, leader, you know, party leader. So later people will join in that one. So then I become a one domain. Okay. And one of when I this one so many years back, of course. Okay, almost like 2010 time, almost 10 or 11, almost 10 time only. So when I went to an institute, he given one beautiful example to understand the domain enterprise kind of stuff. Okay, guys, again, I'm telling here, there's a lot of words are coming, lot of sentences, a lot of words are there. Okay, carefully look at that one, carefully try to understand. Okay. Don't need to think more, just take it as it is. That's enough. Okay, so no need to dig more and more, then you will get confused, I will get confused if you are going. So then one statement is not agree with another statement, so that is the problem in this one. But first of all, try to understand with a simple and direct answer. Here I'm going to give you a small difference, not a difference, it is like when you are creating a domain or a domain controller, so then we have to understand by a normal example only. So in our home, we have one or two PCs. In our, if you take a institute, like a small institutes or maybe a small offices, maybe a 10 or 20 systems. But if you go to the enterprises, you have a lot of systems are there. So then compulsory to control all these PCs, user logins, and policy settings, okay, other related resource access management. So compulsory we required a domain controller. Okay, so now here, so first of all, before we do that, so I want to tell one example. Yes, for example, you want to start a company. Want to start a company. Then what, how you start? Anybody having an idea, like I want to start a company, then what do you think? What are the steps?
Website is needed.
First of all, how to spend the capital first.
Okay. So normal one. So leave about financial matter. Just first an idea of start a company.
Yes. Yeah, so if you have any idea, then you can start.
First, what is your company? Name of the company. That you have to put the name in a construction manner, I'm telling, okay? First of all, some name should be there, no? For example, I want to put my company name is something like sunstarsolutions.com. Okay, sunstarnetwork.com, tutorials.com, or maybe technotes.com or technical.com, tech solutions, like that. So like we'll put some name, right? For example, I'm putting a name. Then where is your company? where is your company? Required, right? So company should be somewhere. Is there? No, it is not Reliance company. It is, it's a company that it means somewhere there is an address should be there. Address, right? Right, address. And you, you alone, like you put some name and you said, hey, this is the address of my company. You directly, can you put a board directly? Like you take a shop, okay? And then you put a label on a company. Savantis.com. Okay, so what is solutions limited or Vedic Soft limited or maybe Tata Enterprises or maybe Tata, for example, Tech Mahindra or maybe Mahindra and Mahindra or maybe Wipro, Infosys, something you put a name directly, like in name board. You can you put it that one? You have to register. You have to register your name and address. You have to register a name and address in a sub-register office. You have to go to a registration office. You have to tell, I'm going to start a enterprise or a company or an organization. So this is my organization name and this is the address. So company people will verify. So is it a unique name or a something is a regular name? So I went to a sub-register office. I paid 100 rupees or 200 rupees, something like I paid a money and I said, I want a name. I'm putting my company name is Infosys. What they will tell? Right, Infosys is a company already existing from so many years. So why you want to put it? Tata, I want to put a Tata company. So I'm not belongs to any Tatas, but I want to start a company. Name is Tata. Okay. So then what they will people tell? So it is this one. So name is should be unique in a public we are using. So compulsory name should be unique and address must be there. You have to register it. So this is the example he given. So how to understand to construct our domain. So first of all, we have to plan what domain you want to create it. Okay. First of all, you have to plan for a domain name. Company, starting of company or anything, that question I will ask in ITL again. So that time I will consider that what is that, financials, idea, business, all kind of stuff we'll discuss guarantee. Now for this one, okay, here for example, for doing the domain, so what we need first, what is the plan for your domain name? For example, I want to put my domain name is, for example, same thing like .com or .org for organizations, .network, .in or a .local. So I'm not going to public, so local only. Or a Microsoft, MSFT. Any extensions, any top level domain you can give, but compulsory top level domain you have to give. Anything .com, .org, .net, .msft, .local, anything you can give. Census.com. Okay, first we have to give a name. We have to plan for a name. Next one is you have to give address. Which address? It is not a domain address, it is your host address, machine address, physical machine address. Domain is a logical, domain controller is a physical server. Domain is a logical, domain controller is a physical server. This server, which means, again, if I said physical server means people think it is a server we are installing in virtualization. How can you tell it is a physical server then? Physical server means physical server only, that's it. Virtual machine you are creating does not mean it is a not a server, it is a virtual server like that. It is not like that. Physical server means it exists, so then where we are interacting it. Logical means it is existing by name, not by direct physical boundaries and all. Domain is a logical, domain controller is a physical. What is the difference? For example, if you take a person, for example, person name is something what is the famous name you can see, most common name, we take a person name, a person is a physical entity, right? Is a person. For example, we are there, okay? So morning I told as an example also, like each individual person is a person, is a physical entity. There are form as a group. Only thing is, the group is a name only. It is not a physical entity. It is just the logically there are belongs to a group, not physically belongs to a group. The not physical boundary it is. Okay, so that is the one. So we have to give IP address of domain controller. I'm planning for a domain controller IP address 172.16.0.240. Just I given a name, guys. When you plan for a IP address, when you plan for a IP address for your system, in we are using completely in the locally only. So we are completely in a local only, not internet connection, nothing is there. So you can put any name, no problem. Example.com, Microsoft.com, Contoso.com, anything you put a name, no problem. Any IP address you can put a no problem. But for IP address and name compulsory, name and top level domain, like a .com, .org, .net, like that, anything we should get. IP address, you can use any IP address, guys, but better not to use these IP addresses. It means don't use this IP address 192 series. Why? Because of your VMware is also giving some VMnet 1 IP address kind of stuff. So you may get confused between your own IP to VMware IP address. So to avoid it, don't use 192 series. You can use anything, private, public, any IP address, you can use it, because we are not going to connect with a regular internet connection. So we are going to complete private now, complete out of physical network. Okay, so I'm choosing this one. So, but why I put a 254? So here it is, for example. What is the meaning of this one here in generally? Which in generally means to whom we give this IP address. To whom by default we are giving this IP address.
First valid IP address.
Very good. First IP address in the network. So this dot ones, to whom we are assigning. We are assigning to host or to assigning to someone. For example, if you check your IP address, so you will get a .100, .101, .102, like that. But 1.1 is specifically for one place it is there. Your IP address, subnet mask, and then one is there. That is, it shows .1s more. Generally, default gateways. Generally, default gateways with this first valid host we are giving to default gateways. It means router IP address. So there is a small difference between default gateway and router. Router has so many interfaces. So some are connected internal and some are connected external, like that. It can be a multiple connections are there. Mainly router is a in-between device, interconnecting device. Inside a local connection, outside of connection it is there. Global connection or internet connection, outside connection is there. Okay. So, router's internal is called a default gateways. for any network, there is a generally one default gateway, that is routers through router, which is your gateway. That's it. What happened suddenly? Unnecessarily plan for a traveling. Guys, be careful. Mainly people who are in Pune and outside of the Pune also. Again, cases are increasing. And because of lockdown, the sample simply they had lift the lockdown. So they didn't lift the lockdown. People are think it is no lockdown, no corona kind of stuff. Okay, so be careful. Okay, domain, IP address. Now what is this? Don't use this one. Okay, okay. I am using this one. You can use any IP address. You can use any IP address. And why I use 254? Because the first one is by default we are giving to default gateways by generally habitual purpose. If you use one, no problem. Instead of this, if you use one also, it will work, no problem. Next one is when you are typing, assigning IP address manually or a thing, okay, so using DHCP server or manually, we are having a hobby of assigning IP address like this, right? So 2.1, 2.2, okay, just like we follow like this. So we'll get confused between a server IP and a normal regular IP, whether it is IP is used or not. So we look after client side, so we keep giving this IP address. So don't give some random IP address, don't give starting IP addresses. Give from last only. Actually, last IP address is different, but just I given a 254 only. In this network, what is the last IP address? What is the last IP address in this network? Actually, last. Last valid. Broadcast. Okay. So this is the last valid and broadcast. For example, if I want to take this network, I can take 254 directly as the last valid IP address. If I'm taking this network, I have to take this one. But I'm not taking, I'm just to make it easy. We have only 2 or 3 pieces maximum we are using here. So for that one, you don't need to plan more things. So why it is a 254 means generally people, while they're assigning IP addresses or pieces IP addresses, we don't think about 200 or 254 like that. We think about 10, 20, 30, or maybe 100, 150 like that only. So we don't cross that one generally. That's why we should use like this. Just for an idea purpose only. You can use any range. I'm using this. You can use anything. No problem. But make sure that what you are using, you have to note down that one. Next. My suggestion is better not to use 1922 series. If you use, it's okay. If you got a problem, it's okay. We'll be there. Okay. So first of all, name of the domain and IP address. Of course, your computer is there, no? So your server. Server means server PC. It is also required a name. This IP address is for a server IP address only. This is a server IP address only. And I need a server PC name. Some name I want to put it. I want to put win S1. Don't put hyphens and underscores, guys. Give straight name only. Okay, better to, you have to change the computer name compulsory. And then this one. So first we have to change the computer name. Then we'll assign an IP address. Okay. Then I will add some more things before I go to create this one. This is just a planning first. Guys, doing is quite easy, but plan and do is a smart work, like that. Okay, first of all, we should know what we are doing it. Guys, first I'm going to do, I'm going to start my server. This is my server. It is connected to VMnet 1. This is functioning. Yes. Okay, so here it is. It is showing. My VMnet 1 I've connected, so I don't want to connect it to internet and it is not required also. I'm using 2GB RAM, one processor, 60GB is enough. Okay, so this is my PC details. So I'm going to power on it. So this is my server. So first duty is, whatever the computer name is, I'm going to change into this name first. After this one, I will assign IP address. After IP address, we'll discuss one by one step. I will tell what I'm going to do it, then I will do it. Okay, so observation is important and it is very, explanation wise, it is very lengthy. Doing wise, it is very less. My sincere suggestion is, don't do parallelly. If you want to do this, you should do this practical, but not same time while I'm doing it. Do it in your free time. Do it in your after class time only. Don't do parallelly. If you do parallelly, you will miss so many points because a lot of wording is there also. Still, it is opening. Okay, so first we have to change the name, IP address for this one. Okay. So what I want to add it here, let it start. Any doubts, guys? I think already I explained domain, right? So domain. So this is what we are doing. This is the server. In the server, we are making this server as a domain controller. Before you make it as a domain controller, what are the steps you do? So we are going to do that one. Okay. Let it start. It will is 2019 only, right? Yeah. Any doubts, ask me please. Any questions? I think already morning I send a Excel sheet. Prepare interview as per that one. It is taking too much time to start. It is installed successfully last time. Guys, I forwarded two PPTs. One PPT, again, I put it into this WhatsApp. So that PPT tell about server, about server, means server 2016. It is tell about server 2016 only, what is their features and all kind of stuff. But when I forward two PPTs, one PPT is about server, second one is Active Directory. It means about what is a domain, what is a domain controller, like that. Okay. If you want to see, like, I will show you. This one, Introduction to Active Directory Domain Services. Yesterday I forwarded it, so check it. There's a lot of, all these definitions are there in that one only. This is a Active Directory thing, okay. Who is there? So I will check the by name. So we'll go with Aditya first. Aditya, can you read the slide? Now it has become a school days. First up to here. In school days, we have a test book, tick marks. Read from here to here. What happened? Is he there or disconnected?
There, sir.
Aditya is here. Here it is.
Getting low voice.
Okay, okay. I'm not able to hear. Then we'll go to someone. Shashank.
Can I?
Okay. Sai Dilip. Continue this one. So from here to here.
Okay, sir. Active Directory Domain Services and its related services from the foundation for the enterprise networks that run Windows operating system.
Okay, wait. So Active Directory. When you hear Active Directory Domain Services or Active Directory, it is belongs to Windows system only. It is belongs to Windows only. Okay, so. Okay, next, this part, the second point. So I will continue. Yeah, continue.
The Active Directory Domain Services database is the central store of all the domain objects, such as user accounts, computer accounts, and groups.
Very good. So here it is. This is the server. Okay, and in the server I install ADDS. This ADDS created database, ADDS database. In this database, what are the store, what it is storing centrally, like user account information, computer account, and group account information stored in a this database. Okay. Some more thing, this is just an introduction one only. This is my, I created this PPT. it has so many things. This is a correct definition. Now it is an important definition will come up from here to here, and then this is a second point, compulsory. This one, this is an explanation about this point. Okay, so this is two points you have to compulsory tell in a interview time or any time. Okay, for understanding also it's quite easy. So any other? Aditya, okay, Pragna, Mike Palam. Yashwant.
Yes, sir.
Read first line up to here, then here.
The ADDS database stores information on user entity, computer group, service and resources. The ADDS domain controllers also host the service. The authenticates user and computer accounts when they log out onto the domain.
Same point again. So this is a server. In this server, I install an Active Directory. Okay. So this will has a database. In this database, it stores user identity, computers, groups, and other resources, services and resources. Resources means printers, scanners. These are all storage. All comes under here only. So it store the information. This is the first point. What is the second point? When user is logging to a computer, that Active Directory domain controller authenticate that user. Control also hosts a service that authenticate users and computers when they log on to the computer. So when they log into computer, for example, user one is logging to the PC A, request is go to Active Directory authenticate user. So that is a second point. So this is a compulsory. Of course, remaining lines are there because ADDS store information about all objects in domain, and all user computer must connected to ADDS domain controller when sign into network. Okay, if you disconnected from domain controller, you may not be signing. ADDS is a primary means by which you configure and manage user account. Something is there. Okay. Guys, understand what is a ADDS? ADDS database store user identity, computer, groups, and resources. ADDS domain control also hosts service that authenticate users and computers account when they log into domain. So these are the main 2 points. I will put a somewhere here it is better. Two points. Okay, so another hand, it is what are the physical component and logical component, data store, domain controller. These are all servers only. So then it is a physical component. Logical means it directly won't exist. It's a name grouping only. So domains, domain tree, schema, partition, forest, sites, and values. This is an explanation of a physical component. Only main important here it is domain controller. What is the domain controller? What is a domain controller? It is a physical server which contains, which stores Active Directory database. A very important one is logical component. Compared to physical component, logical components are important. Guys, compulsory study. Here it is a what is a domain? Domain and then forest. Domain. OU. And then forest, domain tree, site, schema, partition. These are important things. Okay, I put all the check marks, but read it. I'm telling in order wise. Just I'm trying to tell in a order wise. Again, I will put in a different color otherwise. See, first important is what is domain. Then OU, forest, tree, schema, site, partition. Okay, so these are important questions in that order, means priority order. Priority order. Is my PC on or yeah? Alt control inset. Let wait. Okay, it's loading. So I'm clicking on a local server. Okay, so it's a local server. Okay, here it is showing a computer name. This is a work group already. So you need to join to domain and don't join to the domain. Okay, so you should be in work group only. It should be in a work group only. This is IP address. Okay, here if you click here, you will find the IP address part. These are the main things. First, here computer name. Next is IP address part. Computer name is like, look like this one. Look at this computer name. Can you remember? Can you write? We can't do anything with this computer name, right? So we need a normal computer name, which we can able to easily remember, access. Okay. So I'm going to change my computer name first because it will take restart again. Okay. So this is a computer description. You have to go to this option. This is the name work group. This is an option to rename this computer or change it domain or a work group. Click change. So this is the computer name. Now currently it is showing. So I'm removing all this thing and I plan to put a S1 only. So bin S1 meaning is server one. That's it. It's a small and easy. Don't put a big names. Like last batch also someone put a very big name for a computer and domain names and all. Very big names. Not required. So give a meaningful name, easy name to understand that one. Don't give underscores and all. It may give you a problem later. Okay. I'm not changing anything. Member of domain, member of work group, I'll keep in work group only. Then click OK, up. Then click OK, OK, cancel kind of stuff only. How to change the computer name?
Click on the name, sir.
Change.
Next.
Change.
Change. Very good.
The name.
No. You
win. Yes, sir. Click OK. It is asking for restart. OK. Now click on close. Restart now. Compulsory restart now. Why? Because if you don't restart, there is a failure. If you install any services, it won't work properly. We face all the ball. Okay, first restart. Control where it is. Lot of times restart, going to this PC to that PC, like that it is there. Carefully understand, otherwise what we are doing step by step in server side and client side, we have to write down. Like I showed PCA, PCB, while sharing. Same thing all. This entire first part entirely we do in the server only. When it is going on like this, which there is a line is going on now, it means it is refreshing, loading kind of stuff. So you need to hurry, like, so why it is not working? It works. It is like a slow and steady loser I step early. Okay, now IP address name is completed. So what is the second one? IP address. Okay, name completed. Then we have to change the IP address. So this is my Ethernet 0. I can go to ncpa.cpl Ethernet. There I could change it. If I click here, also it will take there only. Okay, this is my Ethernet. See, directly it is showing. Double click. Details. It is showing DHCP enabled, yes. And some auto configuration. So we don't need that one. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to properties. Manually, I'm giving IP address. Compulsory use manual IP address only. All servers, whether it is a domain controller or not, for any servers, assign IP address manually. For a client's, dynamic IP address. But here it is manual IP address only. Okay, IPv4 properties. First option means it is you are getting IP from DHCP server. First option means automatic. Obtain IP address automatically. It means you are getting IP from DHCP server. Use the following IP address. The second option is manual. Same for DNS server also. Same for DNS server also. So I'm selecting here. Okay, use the following IP address. So I have to put my IP address, what I want to put it, and press the tab button automatically subnet mask will come. Why it is showing 255.255.0.0?
It's class A, sir. Sorry, class,
it's a class B. Very good. Okay.
Network, host.
Yes. Correct. Okay, default gateway. So what is the IP address I have to give default gateway? It is not connected to any router or any default interfaces, gateway interfaces. It works in same network only. Nothing, no need to give anything. Okay. Next, preferred DNS server. Preferred DNS server, you have to give DNS server's IP address. The question is, who is your DNS server? We are in some complete private network, separate LAN network, right? So we don't have any public DNS servers also. So who is your DNS server? We'll be back to DNS server once again. This is the IP address. Now tell me how to put an IP address.
Open IP.
Right click. Properties. Very good.
Use the following IP address.
Okay, good. So I'm going to give a DNS address after I explaining it only. Okay, close. Okay, like this. Now I give an IP address, but it should be show here. It is not showing immediately because it will take 10 minutes to refresh itself. Every 10 minutes, server manager will be refresh itself. Okay, so this is my IP address, and this is my IP address and IPv4 address. IPv6 is enabled, so I am not able to see the IPv4 IPv6 address directly here because it's only local address work. Okay, and in this practical, I don't need IPv6. If you don't need, you can unselect it. If you need it, you can leave it also, no problem. So what I'm going to do is I want to disable IPv6. So very simple, go to properties, go to IPv6, go to IPv6, unselect this one, unselect IPv6. So no IPv6 communication. Actually, it is not required to remove it. But I'm removing it. That's it. Not much. So once I remove, it is not showing immediately. Just click on refresh. Okay. Next. So see, it is gone. Now, what is the next point we have to tell? I said DNS server. Okay, so what is the DNS server address? Before that one, who is your DNS server? Guys, listen carefully. When we are installing, ADDS, just we are installing ADDS role only. We are installing ADDS role only. Okay. Normally, you have to take compulsory separate systems. Right, this is busy. Here it is. This is your domain controller, and this is separate DNS server is there. For example, this is a .254. This is a .253. For example, this is an IP address. Now, client want to log in. So client don't know domain controller IP address directly. Client don't know domain address or domain controller address, he don't know. So he has to log in into his PC. Okay, for example, PC A, user one is trying to log in, but he has to reach the domain controller for authentication, right? You don't know how to reach the domain controller. So what you do? First, you'll contact DNS. In DNS, where is this domain controller? And what is that domain controller IP address? So DNS will give us IP address, and then using IP address we can able to communicate. So there is somewhat a few more steps are there, but understand these steps. So user want to log into the PC, so he has to communicate with domain controller, but he don't know which IP address of domain controller. So what it will do, it will ask DNS server, where is my domain controller and what is that IP address? So you got IP address, you will communicate with the domain controller. So this is a very simple one. Then we'll go to another one. Okay. What is the another one? It is, we don't have separate PCs. This is your ADDS role is installed here. It means you become a domain controller. While you are become a domain controller, it will ask, do you want to install DNS or not? It will ask, do you want to install DNS server or not? So if you say okay, check mark, then automatically your server become DNS server. So we don't put a DNS separately. We use same system as a DNS server. It means this PC itself a domain controller because Active Directory domain resources, and DNS is also installed here. So you are a DNS server. You are a DNS server. Yourself DNS server. Okay. So now tell me, what is the DNS server IP address?
.53 at last only. Other than that, all same. What
is your DNS server address? Your server is a DNS server address. Your server is itself DNS server. Then what is the IP address?
Only. Yes. 254 only.
254 only because your PC,
DNS server is
both are there in same. Okay. So then automatically ourselves DNS server. Okay. Got the point, right? If it is separate DNS server can be there, but both are same only. Just like, you know, no, not required example because you understand. Okay. Now, again, I want to give DNS server address. Compulsory, you should give DNS server address. Same thing like IPv4. I disable IPv6. This is IPv4 properties. Here, I'm giving same address. So we given, but we can't see properly, but we given. Okay. Now this part is completed. So next part is, what is a next part? You have to install ADDS role. You have to install ADDS role. Okay. Now, how to install the ADDS role? Go to server manager, manage, add roles, and teachers. Okay. Then wizard will start. I use next, like that. Under roles, I'll select active directory. Domain service. Next. Finally, install. There is a check mark. You have to check it at a installation time. Restart if it required. When it is required or if it is required. And install. Okay, now tell me, I'm in a server manager, so where I have to go?
Manage
dashboard,
add roles and features. Okay, this is the tools. In tools, after installation, what are the installation thing happened? I have to check it. Now it should be a little bit up. Okay, so here if you want to read it, destination server, it is showing like this. Okay, first option only in this installation, we are using on-premises, not virtual machines or VDK or desktop kind of stuff. Okay, first option only.
Yeah.
This is also first, like same thing only. This is a... Yeah, tell me. It's okay. First, select server from server pool. Okay, leave like that only, so don't change anything. It is happening. So better not to close while it is going on. What is server pool means? Number of server pool means this is a server. It is my server. If in case I have a multiple servers in the network, so I can install into that server from here also. For example, I have a S2, so I want to install in S2. I can install it from here also. That's why it is separate.
You can try to close it and do it again. I think it's crashed.
It is very danger.
It is.
Local server means this PC. All servers means, so different PCs we are accessing from single server manager, like that you can have it. I restarted my PC after this one, right? Changing name.
Yes, sir. It's
very slow.
Harmeet came, sir.
Came? Then click on next. You can see roles. Yesterday it came.
Line roles. Adding roles. ADDS.
I will sign out and sign in. Maybe just tracking somewhere.
Sir, should I ask, share my screen?
How?
If you say, sir, because I am getting that option the next step.
Who is? Tell me.
Sir, Vishal.
Vishal. Now you become a presenter. We can share the screen.
Just a second. Are you able to see?
No. Maybe it will take time.
Yeah,
now I'm getting.
Yeah. Hey, it's active.
How to full screen this one? Why the screen is very small? Okay. That's that option only. No problem for me. What you do? Your left side of the window, there is a cross mark. Is there no? Left side library. Close the library. At least you will get little bit proper view of your screen.
After this, what we should select, sir?
That one only, the second one, Active Directory Domain Services.
Sorry, sir, I guess network disconnected.
The network problem, you got it.
It is asking for add feature that are required for directory domain services.
One second. Okay, the screen, your screen not visible. It is stuck there only.
Sir, whose screen is this?
Vishal.
No, sir, I have lost connection. I have to reshare it. I'm not sharing it.
Okay. Yeah, for me it is working.
Okay, sir. Sir, I don't have the screen sharing option anymore, sir. It's got stuck. The meeting got stuck, okay. I guess.
Now, are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay, we'll see here. So this is, click here. So it is ask add roles and future wizard, add features. Okay, just click on add features. Select this one, box appear, add features. Okay. Next. Now, no need to add anything here. Next. Next. Select this one. Click yes. Okay. Select this one. It asks something like yes. You have to click on yes and click on install. Guys, I'm going to click on install. Okay. Or can I go back and I have to show the options?
Show the options.
Okay, so I'm going to starting from here, you know, right? Add roles and features. Next, no need to change here. No need to change anything here. Okay, only second option. Okay, so when you just click here, you find a description. And when you click on this one, okay, it show a box actually. Otherwise, you have to close. Again, I'm getting doubt whether it is works or not. Okay. First option. Just leave for that first option only. Correct one only. So, can you see Active Directory Domain Services? Second one. The blue color highlighted.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, when you select this one, when you select this box, automatically pop-up will come up like this. Okay. So, add features. Select add features. Okay. Then, do nothing. Here also, don't do anything. Just go. Go to the last directly, select this one. It is not required, but select this one. Then click yes, install. So I'm clicking, can I click on install?
Yes, sir.
Let it install, okay? So after installation, again, wizard part is there. Guys, what I'm going to do is I stop all this record and take a 10-15 minutes break. It will be back in 5 minutes only. Check 10 minutes break. Okay.
Sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, in Excel, I found a question that how to connect the UDP connection. If the UDP connection is lost, then how to connect?
No. I put a connection, not that one. I put a connection. If UDP connection, UDP is a connectionless.
Now, if UDP then how is it connectionless, is then who connect?
How it connects?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, this is a question given from one of our previous batch student because he got that question from interviewer. Actually, TCP is a connection-oriented protocol. UDP is a connection-less protocol. What is that meaning is TCP type of protocols, when the sender means source send a packet to destination, once it is sent, it will receive an acknowledgement from the destination. Okay?
Okay, sir.
I send a packet, I receive an acknowledgement. And again, I send a packet, I will receive acknowledgement for each and every packet. So, source understand, packet is delivered. That is called connection oriented. Just for simple example. You are, for example, two-way communication is there. Like one person is asking question, another one is answering or telling I received. Okay, for example, your friend asked you money. You send a money. Then what you receive? Transaction ID, successful transaction. Transaction proof is there, no? You pay money to Savantis. Like for example, you paid 10,000 today. What you will get it? Immediate receipt you will get it, right? So we received it. By that one you understand other person is received. That is a connection oriented. Okay? Connection less. What is a connection less? You send money, no reply, nothing. You send a letter.
No account.
You don't know whether it is reached or not. Yes, no acknowledgement. No acknowledgement. You send packet, you don't receive any acknowledgement. Again, you send a packet. Again, you send a packet. You don't know whether it is reached or not. It may be reached, may not be reached, but we don't know reached or not. So that is like a connectionless protocol. So they ask like this. So obviously we confused, no? Based on a question.
Yes,
so obviously, you know, what is TCP? What is UDP? Connection, connectionless. We read the definitions, we read the tables, but actually what is the mechanism, we don't mind about it. Okay, so that's why Cognizant interviews are like that. Even last time one batch, the batch 3 only, I start asking questions. When I'm taking DevOps, I start asking questions about what is a subnet mask for a class D? D. A, B, C, D. Subnet mask for a class D. What it is? Class D subnet mask.
255.255.255.0.
That is class C.
No, subnet.
All 255.
In my class, may I told anytime class D subnet mask?
No, sir. Okay. Class, only up to C.
Class then C. Why I didn't tell about D?
It's not class C.
No, sir.
Right? Yeah. No class, no subnet mask for class D. It won't use any subnet mask, okay? Because multicasting don't have network portion and host portion only. They use by services only, okay? So that's it. So okay. When this kind of questions will come up, definitely we got a little bit confused and disappointment, right? So like, you know, I don't know what happened. Sir, not told us. This is what happening, like, okay? So that's why you need a practice, means discussion is important. Then the barriers will be reduced. Like that question you asked, question, right? That networking question. So instead of searching in a Google, try to discuss the question. That's from starting day onwards, I'm telling. You guys take 1/2 hour time. You guys, yourself only, you, maybe 5 members or 10 members or all members, put it in a one small meeting. Start discuss on one simple topic. Simple topic, one networking or maybe a Windows 10. Start discussing questions, asking questions. Doubts will be clarified. And start thinking will be increased. Okay? Most of my knowledge by questions only. Lot of people asking different type of questions. Then I learn from that one only. Okay, break. Have a tea, coffee, don't sleep. I am getting sleep. Okay. So be back at 10 minutes, 4:25.
This conference will now be recorded.
Okay. Everyone is here.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if you see here, it is showing promote this server as a server to a domain controller. Promote this server to a domain controller. Just you have to click on this one. So then, domain controller wizard will work. Now, up to now, we are installed role only. So you just install a role, but it is not a domain controller. Just it contains a service. That's it. Not a domain controller. So just if you click on this one like this, so the wizard will start. It should be start. Yes, it is started now. So it is Active Directory Domain Service Configuration Wizard. Okay, so it is giving some options. So we'll see what is each individual options also. Okay, like that. Okay, so I'm closing this one. For example, just for example, you close by accidentally, like you didn't wait up till once it is completed installation. So you didn't wait, it just you closed it by accidentally, just like that. Then how to open that wizard? The simple, you can go to this flag symbol. The flag is the action menu symbol type only, action symbol. Okay, so it is showing warning, right? So the warning symbol. So here you can find promote this server to a domain controller. Just if you click it, again wizard will start. Or otherwise, in the right left side you can see ADDS. Okay, left side you can see ADDS. Click on ADDS. You can see configuration required for Active Directory services at a server name, right? You can see more in the right side. Just click on the more. You can find a post deployment configuration, promote this server to a domain controller. Here also you can find this link. Okay, so before I going to that one, so before I going to show you that promote this server to a domain controller part. Okay, so I will show you something. Like you can go to tools. These are all added after you install ADDS. Active Directory, Administrative Center, Domain Center, Sites and Services, Users and Components, ADSI Edit, Group Policy Management. These are all added after ADDS role is installed. Okay. For example, I'm going to Users and Computers. Active Directory, Users and Computers. Tools, Active Directory, Users and Computers. Something it is showing, it is to manage users and groups in on this computer, use local users and groups only. To manage users, groups and domain, log in as a user with a domain administrator rights. Okay, this is Active Directory, Users and Computers. If you see there is a cross mark, it means you don't have a database in your PC. Just you install a role, but it is not a domain controller. No domain database is not created here. Okay, it is just a cross mark only. This window is useful, like if you want to connect it to another domain controller or other domain and you want to manage from this window, you can manage it remote access only at present. But if you become a domain controller, so you can access yours also. So I'm closing this one again. Select here, promote this server to a domain controller. Now I'm going to promote this one as a domain controller. Just click there. You got a wizard. Okay. Got the point, guys. How to open the configuration wizard. This flag symbol, click here. You'll find a promote this server to a domain controller. Just click there. Wizard will start. And it is giving a three options. What is these three options? And what is this option? I will explain first. New one. There it is. Yes, again, I'm telling a story. Just carefully understand the story. It is Okay. Always I take an example of Tata only. Always I'll take an example of Tata industry because it's a very large industry and best example and so many years it is there. So Tata Industries. Okay. So first of all, the Tata people, JRD Tata, Jamshed Tata, like those people are started Tata Enterprises, right? So when they started, it is the first Tata. It is the first one. The whole enterprises. Tata has so many branches, but so many kind of MNC companies, so many other things are there. So, but they started a first Tata. So then it has become their first enterprise. So in our domain language, it is a first domain. And they have their domain controller. So in this domain controller, they said, mine is a Tata industry, Tata.com, like that. So they put a name of this domain is Tata.com, for example. Okay. So this is in enterprise. This is the first one. Okay. This is the first one. Later, Tata people think, so they started different industries. Okay. So for example, Tata Steel. TataSteel.com. So like that. Okay, of course it is become big. Otherwise, we put a small letters, then it is small. TataSteel.com. Just Tata Steel. Okay. So this is another domain. This is a another domain they created. So another domain, it means it contains a another domain controller. Okay. What is this triangle? Triangle represents domain. The PC like this, this square rectangle one that is represent domain controller server. And also they started so many businesses. So I will put those businesses here. Only one or two examples only. So for example, TCS. What is this things? These are all their trees. This is a root domain. This is, we call it as a root domain because it started in the starting. So when they started a root domain, so they started forest. When you are install a root domain, automatically you install a forest. The round one represent forest. So you have to write down, so like here it is. This is the forest. This is forest. This is Tata Forest. And this domain is root domain. This domain we call it as a root domain in the forest or a forest level domain, forest domain. So based on whenever we created Tata.com, we created a Tata Forest. We created a Tata Forest. And after that one, we created a TCS.com, TataSteel.com. These domains, we call it as a tree domains.
Trees.
It is a forest. In a forest, it is a tree. Okay. Everything is in the same forest only. It connecting means it's either it is a tree or a child. Okay. So this is a tree domains. These two are a tree domain. This is a root level domain. For example, I have one more is there now. So not so many are there. Not one more. Just for an example, I keep putting here. My example. For my example, Tata Steel is not one. Okay. So I'm changing to another domain, which is TataMotors.com. Okay, so it is a TataMotors.com, for example. Okay, it is a Motors.com or TataMotors.com. Okay, it is also a tree domain. This is also a tree domain. Okay, now what I done, so I want to that motor, now it is a electrical motors are came, no? So electrical motors also came. it is also, for example, just for example, understanding only. Okay, so I created a child domain. I created a child domain under motors.com. So I put a electricalmotors.com. Electric.motors.com. Okay, motors.com, normal motors, Tata Motors. But this is, I put a electric.motors.com or Tata Motors.com. So what happened? This we call it as a child domain. This we call it as a, I'll put it here, child domain. So the whole, we call it as a total enterprise is a forest. In the forest, we have a trees and childs also there. This child can be under a tree or under a root also possible. Like if I want to create a child here, I can also create a child. If you observe a difference between each and everything, this is a Tata.com, means main enterprise domain. Administrator of this domain is an admin for everyone. Like a CEO of Tata industry is a CEO of all Tata industries, right? Who is the current CEO of Tata? Any name you can tell?
Ratan Tata.
Okay, Ratan Tata. Actually, he is retired.
He is chairman.
He is not.
He's not, but.
He's chairman.
He changed. Now, some.
Tamil, I know name the TCS, is, but not the Tata. It was something Satyanarayan.
Yeah, Satyanarayan something.
Yeah.
Narayan something is there. Okay, now for example, Ratan Tata, so because we know that name only. CEO of Microsoft? Microsoft CEO.
Satya
Nadella. Yeah,
Satya Nadella. Satya Nadella is not the CEO anymore, sir. He is, I guess.
Recently he changed it, sir. Recently.
No more the CEO.
Recently changed? Satya Nadella also.
Yes.
Amazon CEO going to be changed. Anyway.
Yeah.
Satya Nadella is going to be CEO.
Cognizant CEO?
No. Cognizant.
Brain Humphries. Brain Humphries. Yeah. That is interview question. Brian Humphries. Brian Humphries.
Brian
Humphries. Actually, earlier it is Francisco D'Souza is there earlier.
I have read that it was originally made from by a Sri Lankan person.
Yeah, Sri Lankan and a Goa person. Goa person is Francisco D'Souza, Kumar Mahadevan is a Sri Lankan.
Kumar.
So there are founders.
Yes.
Kumar Mahadevan is a founder. Cognizant is Indian company actually. By Indians.
Right. Indian and Sri Lankan combination.
Indian Sri Lankan company.
Everything is led by Indian founders.
We are
telling. So it's American,
right now it is.
Yeah, it is a service provider. It's not a which country. It is a MNC, means it's a multinational company. No country owning any company it is. And it is a service oriented, means clients can be anywhere.
Yes, yeah, I know.
It is better to be nearest to the client, like that. Most of your profile clients are Indians only. Very less.
Cognizant have more out of 2.3 lakhs employees, more than 1.5 are Indians only.
I got a parallel call, that's why I didn't hear. Okay, good. Okay, know about your CEO and all. Okay, so we'll go back to this one because this time is also good. Yep. So for example, Ratan Tata is a CEO of everyone, right? Not only for Tata Motors, not only for like this, right? So like that, this admin means this domain, root level domain admin, by default is an enterprise admin. By default, he become an enterprise admin. So he can control entire domain, domain trees and everything. Okay. Next, this is a tree domain. It is in a part, it is in the forest, but it won't share name like this. Name like this, it won't share. Tata.motors.com, it won't come. Tata.motors.com by name it will come, but not as a dot as something it is won't come. Okay, it share both common schema and naming system, but actually it won't ask you to who is your parent kind of stuff. Just name it is enough for that one. Individual name only, but it is under same forest only. But child will carry the parent name. Child will carry the parent name. See, it is electric.motors.com like that, or motors.electrical.com. That we can, it has, this is the child, this is the parent name, like a subdomain type only. Okay, so this is the trees, this one, this is up to here. Now I told 3 points. First, I told 3 points. What is it? Forest, root level domain. Because if when you create this domain, then only forest is created. Okay, first company we started. Later, a lot of establishment came, right? So then tree, domain, child domain. So root, tree, child. Now I want to tell one more thing. Not one more, there are two more things, three more things, four more things. Just keep going on. Okay. So this is another domain. Okay, this is another domain controller, not domain. The box symbol represent domain, right? So this is a domain controller. This is additional domain controller. This is additional domain controller. So I have a domain controller is like a main copy of things. Any changes we do in a domain controller. Why it is additional domain controller? Additional domain controller. You have a domain controller and additional domain controller. Why need a additional domain controller and what is the additional domain controller? If in case I have a lot of users are there, like a 500 users, 1000 users, 2000 users are there. Everybody morning shift only, 9 o'clock shift only. So people are started login. So one single domain controller cannot handle entire traffic. So we need a load balancer. So that's why we use second one, additional domain controller. So both will share the load. So one purpose is for load balancing. Next, if in case domain controller is down, all users accounts are stored in domain controller only. So who will authenticate users? It's no authentication, right? So we need a additional domain controller. If in case domain controller is down, additional domain controller will give you authentication. Got the point? Like this, you can create a multiple additional domain controllers. Multiple additional domain controllers you can create. It depends upon a company and a risk factor. So they create an additional domain controller. And one more domain controller is there. That name of domain controller is RODC. Read-only domain controller. So I place a domain, I want to place a domain controller in the branch office, but branch offices, again, we have to provide a lot of security for that one. It is all it is cost, and as well as the security cost increases, server cost increases, everything will be there. So in that one, I place RODCs, means it's a domain controller, but read-only copy only, read-only domain controller. It means you cannot change any data in this PC. And in the branch, for example, in the branch, 100 users are there. Only 100 users' passwords only replicate. Not everyone's passwords will replicate. ADC, all users' information and their passwords are also there in the ADCs. But RODCs, based on a specific user, those users' passwords only stores here. All user in list will come, but only specific user passwords only will come. So it won't authenticate everybody in the branch. Only the branch people only. Okay. So this is RODC. Mainly RODC means read only domain controller. Domain controller, additional domain controller, RODCs. Three things. Okay, guys, again, forest root means first domain controller. It means when you create this one, you are creating a forest. If forest is available, then only we can create tree or child. Then only we can able to create tree or a child. We can able to create. Got it? Forest must be there. Otherwise, you can't create a tree or child. Next one. Every domain has a domain controller. Every domain has a their own domain controller is there. Every domain has a their own domain controller is there. So this domain controller for load balancing and failover, we require a additional domain controller. Number of additional domain controller we can add it depends upon your seriousness, risk, load, or like that. Okay. And another domain controller is there. It like a additional domain controller only. It is RODC, read only domain controller. It means we cannot add a except if you log in as a domain admin, then we can able to change the records, but we can't change normally. Read only domain controller admin cannot change records. Only he can take the record from DC or ADC, but he cannot modify the records here because it's a read only copy only. And not all the user passwords, only a specific user based passwords only will get it. Okay, so there are three things actually. Again, I'm going back to my server. If you see here in the down, the last one is add a new forest. Forest is not yet there. Now I want to add a new forest. So that is a last option. Second option. If you want to create a tree or a child, that is second option. See, you want to create a forest, that is last option. You want to create a tree or a child, it is a second option. Child domain or tree domain. What is the first option? You want to create ADC or RODC. You want to create ADC or RODC, first option. Got it?
Yes, sir.
First time, no? It's a little bit time taken for digest. Okay? Yeah. So, if you select the last one, can you see root domain name? It is asking your first forest name. Which one you want to create? You are creating a new forest along with new domain. If you select the second one, it is asking select domain type. Tree type or child type. So I'm selecting tree, forest name, new domain name. It means first you have to create a forest, then you have to take another server, then you have to create a tree domain in that one if you want to create. Then you have to tell forest name and new domain name. Next, it is child domain. You have to say parent, not a tree, not a root, anything. Any domain, the parent. So it required any domain. So first you have to take a existing domain, then give the new name for the domain. Next, this one. First one, it is asking, give me a domain name. That's it. It is not asking existing domain or anything. Just you need a domain. What are the name you're given? Domain name. Then the server become additional domain controller or RODC, depends upon what configuration you done. So I'm going to select new forest. Okay. So because why we should select a new forest?
First time, sir.
Yeah, first time. Okay. First time. No, we don't have any forest.
We don't.
Okay. Now I plan for my forest name is sunstar.com. This is my planning. Does not mean you have to put the same name. You can put apple.com, biscuit.com, anything you can do it. Chocolate.com, abcd.com. Okay, so I'm giving sunstars.com. .com, .org, .net, .local, .msft, any extension you give, but compulsory extension required.
That's what I'm asking. Like, extension is compulsory.
Extension is compulsory. Any extension, org, .net, or .local, .msft, like that, anything. I am giving .com, so why we think more, then I give in like that. Okay. Next, New Forest, do domain name. Okay. Next, let it go on. It will take time, so let it. Now it is working. Forest function level, domain function levels are 2016, it is showing. If you see, it is a lower version also showing. Okay, it is not showing that one. So if you select here, then it will change. Each is dependent on other one. So what is this functional level means? The futuristic differences are there. For example, in my big network, I have a 2008 server running. This is 2019. There may be a future differences are between certain future differences are there. Between 8 and 19. So they won't cooperate each other. So I'm telling use this future, but 8 don't understand that future. So we have to reduce our functional level. So that is become more administrative work. So don't worry about it. If you see three options, last option is not selected and it is disabled because it's a read-only domain controller and we didn't select the first option. So then obviously we are not doing this one. Next one is check mark and gray. So you cannot uncheck this middle one. Global catalog server. The first domain controller. So first domain controller in the forest automatically is a global catalog server. It's a global catalog server is nothing but a server only, not a domain. Next, it is optional. You want to install a DNS server or not. If you have a DNS server separately, then you can use the DNS server address. If you don't have a DNS server separately, better to install DNS server here. Without a DNS, you can't work with a domain. Okay, so select a DNS server compulsory. This is a directory restore mode password. For example, if you backup your Active Directory database, then you want to restore it, you need a password. But I'm giving password is admin@123 only. I'm not giving differently. Don't try to give differently. If you give differently, compulsory remember that password. That's it. I put a enter. Okay, next. No problem. Okay, this is a created DNS delegation. Means if you are having a DNS separate server, so you will mention that one. So then definitely you have to give check mark here and you have to give some permissions. Because some data is going to be stored in your DNS from your Active Directory. So this is nothing to do it. Just go for next. NetBIOS name. This is a domain NetBIOS name. Remember, it is asking domain NetBIOS name. I will explain what is domain NetBIOS name. Domain NetBIOS name means you are giving a domain name with .com, right? It remove the .com. Domain NetBIOS name is the only main domain name only, not front one, not a back one. Means not a host one, not a extension one, not a subdomain one. Only what is that particular domain means. That only it will come. And make sure that your server name and domain name should not be same. Should not be same. You know, some people are name freakies are there. So a lot of freaky people are there, like a fitness freak type. Okay. Name freaks are there. I don't know why people are like that. Sometimes happens. They like their name very more. So what they use, server name is their name only. For example, we take an example, Urvi. Okay, server name is Urvi, domain name is Urvi, username is Urvi, and client name is Urvi. Client username is also Urvi. Then what happened? Which Urvi you are working, we don't know. Okay, so it will confuse you to do it. Okay, Urvi is an easy name, very good name actually, it's simple name. I have a one good
sir,
friend.
This will appear by itself.
What it is?
So this name is in domain name. It will appear by itself.
Yeah, it will appear by itself only. You don't need to give. Automatically, it will come. Okay. So to avoid the confusion between your server, client, and your domain names and user names, better to give a separate name only. So make sure that important one is server name and domain name should not be shared. This is your server name, physical server name. This is a domain name. Okay, so it automatically comes. So when you done previously, next automatically detects from your domain name only. Okay, without .com it came. I have one student is there, so we are in record. No problem. She will laugh then. So it's my 18 batch student only. Her name is Akanksha Deshmukh. Some name like that it is. So when I given a name, so repeated demo DC1 like that, she put a name like this. Server name is Akanksha, domain name is Deshmukh, and some extension given. I seen she got some problem. I seen I scroll her like a, if you are giving this very big names, even if someone want to hack your system, they lose interest. Because they're still looking at their name also. Someone try to hack your system also, because of that big name, they lose their interest. What is this name? Very big names. Okay. So put a small names. Mainly like S1, B1, like that. This is very good one names. Okay, guys. This is a C Windows NTDS. This is a database folder. So your database, Active Directory database. Active Directory database name is ntds.dit. Active Directory database name is ntds.dit. It stores in this folder. And along with some log files also there, that is also stores in this folder. This is a sysfol. Sysfol is a domain public shared folder. Domain public shared folder. Usually like a group policies, few things will be stored here only. Okay. Also try what is the sys folder also. What is this? NTDS.DIT. What is your Active Directory database name? Active Directory database name.
NTDS.DIT.
Very good. Abbreviation.
No idea.
Very good. What is NT? Okay, guys, these are what are the settings you
new click? Technology.
Very good. Very good. New technology. These are the settings what we so far we done. This is a view script. If you click on a view script, it will tell you how to install with a PowerShell. If you copy this one and put it in a PowerShell, obviously you can create your own domain also. This is the temporary file. If you want to save it, it's not a compulsory. Just if you want to save it, then you can save it in a file also. We don't have any separate folder, so then we are saving in C drive. Okay, I said DC config. Just for a text file only I'm saving, so not much. Okay, so it is not important. Just go for a next. Now it is checking pre-request, all pre-requests correct or not. If it is showing a red color, definitely it is an error. Read the red color, what happens? Either two issues: after changing computer name, you didn't restart your computer. Second issue is, okay, second issue is you didn't put a DNS address. Okay, so it is all pre-request passed successfully. Ignore the warnings, but errors we should check it. If any error occur, you don't get a install button also. Okay, so I got install button, click on install button, and it will take another 5 to 10 minutes maximum time to install it. Okay, meanwhile domain controller. Okay, so this is a wizard, right? So how many people remember steps in wizard? So what is the third option you have to select, right? Third one, what is it? Add a new forest. In the box you have to give domain name, domain.com.
Name.
Hmm?
Yes.
Okay, yes, some name. I'm not giving. Okay, I'm giving name, right? So I will give that name. Sun Stars. Okay, you can give your own name, no problem. So, okay. If you got any problem, just put it in a group. I will connect and I will check it. Okay, third option. Then you have to give DSRM password. Remaining, all check marks only, don't change anything. And I given a password is admin@123 two times. Okay, and next, what to do? Nothing. And next, what to do? It is asking DNS kind of stuff. Then it will ask for a net BIOS. Okay, so in the next window, so then you'll go with so somewhere net BIOS kind of stuff. Okay, so net BIOS, just check it, nothing, you don't need to do anything. After next, locations just for checking purpose only. And next, pre-request completed, and finally install. So this is done. So you have to wait till it is completed. Okay, so once it is completed, it will restart automatically. Okay, so this is a setup. Once it is came back, so it shows like this. So it means you are become a, earlier if you observe, it is only administrator. Now it is a domain administrator. Give the password, login. So this is, give the password, just login. Okay, this is your first part. Yeah, it is restarting. Let it restart, or you just, you can close this one, or you can leave it like that. So no problem, then automatically restart, leave it like that, don't do anything. So here it is, Active Directory database, ADBS database. What it is, ntds.dit. Active Directory database name is ntds.dit. Very good. Nt, first of all, when you see an nt means new technology.
D.
What is Bahman. D? Active Directory. Bahman. What is AD? Active Directory. Directory service, new technology, directory service, DIT, directory information tree. Okay, very big one, right? So new technology, directory service, directory information tree. Remember guys, ADDS, Active Directory Domain Services. But in NTDS, domain won't come, directory will come. D means directory in NTDS. NTDS.DIT, totally directory only. So a new technology, directory service, directory information tree. Our Active Directory Windows use Kerberos authentication system. Use Kerberos authentication system mainly, and also it use LDAP also. It both use Kerberos and LDAP. So mainly NTDS means your Active Directory authentication means Kerberos authentication system. So here it is, ADDS database, ADDS authentication Kerberos. Anybody want to tell port number for Kerberos and LDAP? Checking in textbook or internet?
Yeah, maybe, sir, it was around 80, 90. I don't remember it.
the port numbers, you have to keep on chanting. I told port numbers, right? So you have to keep chanting like every time. So everything you see, like you open a web page, HTTP port number, HTTPS port number, like that, you have to keep chanting.
389.
And we see in few things here in the setting. So what are those things also we have to write? Forest domain. Okay, so already I given a domain definition. Forest tree child traditional domain controller or what it is. Additional domain controller RODC is global catalog. These are physical servers only. In physical servers only. These are all are boundaries only. Now see sunstars/administrator. This administrator is a domain administrator and forest administrator, enterprise administrator, because this is a forest and everything, right? So this is the domain. So forget about this is a domain name and this is the administrator name. This administrator, this user account is a administrator, and I'm logging admin at that 123. Now it taken another 2 minutes to log in finally. Okay, so this is your server. Now your server is a no one is talking. This is a server, right? Earlier
it's a domain.
Now it is a domain controller, and also it is a DNS server. Okay, so DNS server is in a secondary, but now it is a domain controller. We make a server as a domain controller. Okay. For example, I have a server. It means server means this is a server one. For example, this is a server two. I have a server. This server not in the domain. It is not a domain controller. I didn't install any services in that. Just install a operating system only. What is the name of this server? Is a standalone server. Okay, standalone server, a standalone server. Okay, standalone server. What is a standalone server? The server is not a specific server. It is a just a server operating system is installed. That is called a server. Standalone server. For example, if I install DHCP in this one, then it become DHCP server, like a particular service server. Still it is a standalone server if it is not belongs to any domain or domain controller. Okay, for example, this server is joined to the domain. Okay, this server joined to a domain. It join into a my domain. Okay, it join into my domain. Okay, is a now this server is a member of a domain. Server is a this server is a member of domain, my domain. This server we call it as a member server. This server we call it as a member server. If it is a not a member of server, it's a standalone server. If it's a member of domain, it's a member server. You got the point? Standalone means not belongs to any domain. Member server means is a member of a domain. If you install domain controller ADDS, it become a if you configure as a domain controller, it become a domain controller. Otherwise, it become a member server only. If you install a Putler service, also we can call this server as a that Putler service server also. Don't worry. Now I may become a domain controller. As I show last before I make this one as a domain controller, I showed in a tools Active Directory users and computers. I showed in my computer Active Directory users and computers, right? So there it is showing a cross mark like that, right? Earlier. Now I am going to show you this one. So can you see there is no cross mark, and also it is showing like this. It is, see, can you my domain name and some data also showing. Earlier it is not showing, now it is showing. The difference is earlier this server is just ADDS role is installed, now it become a actually domain controller database is created. And also verify what is these things. You can see a lot of groups, only one user is there. The username is administrator. Okay, and all are normal users groups also there. Computers are not there, no computers are there. Domain controller is itself a domain controller, so that's why it is their name only it is showing. Users, there's users and as well as a number of groups, by default groups in this one are there. So these under domain, what are the things you are seeing? Built-in computers, domain controllers, users. These are all called containers or OUs. Containers or OUs. Just like a folder contains a data, same thing like it is a container or a OU, organizational units. That's it. Yeah.
So from where to open this Active Directory? Can you please tell me what?
Tools.
Tools.
Active Directory, users and computers.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Guys, if you see here, it is earlier domain. Here it is showing workgroup, computer name, and it is showing workgroup. Now automatically it is a part of domain. Okay. And some people ask me a question, that is, sir, how many in one domain controller? It is a server, right? In one domain controller, how many domains we can able to create? How many domains you can create in a single domain controller? Okay, think and your voice is not clear for me. That's it. So what is the question I asked? In one domain controller, how many domains you can able to create? Okay, guys, I'm just take a 5 minutes break. Just a 5 minutes. I'm going to stop recording also.
This conference is no longer being recorded.